In this section, we will see one by one all the basic chart categories. We will start from column charts. They are often used to compare discrete items. The most common is cluster column chart. It's widely used by many people and the data looks clearly on the chart. We can also see the detail that data represents. It's easy to notice that word from 2014 has the most sales. If we want the total at a glance, it's better to use stacked column chart. You see that it's also easier to read it. For example, year 2012 and 2014 have almost the same sales. And if you take a look at totals, it's obvious that they have similar sales. So very useful, this type of chart. If we look below, we can see a variation of stacked column chart called 100% stacked column. The main difference there is that we don't see the total amount of sales, but the proportion of them. For example, look at Excel from year 2013. It has the smallest proportion of all the other program softwares. To the right side, we have a three-dimensional cluster column chart. Also below this, there is a three-dimensional column chart. And both of these charts have a better visual appearance than other charts. And they are really impressive, but not so practical. Look, for example, the values. You can't read them easily, especially in this chart. Now we will learn some useful settings and features of that type of charts. Notice that almost all charts have a space between the columns. This feature is called gap width. Slide over clustered column and right-click on one of the columns, then choose Format Data Series. A dialog box appears called Format Data Series. We are interested at Series Option tab. Look at gap width setting. If we decrease it, for example, 50%, we will notice that the columns are getting closer. Let's increase to 300%. The same goes with other types of charts like stacked columns or 3D columns. Let's try to stack column. Click any column, decrease the gap width to 40% and see the difference. Series overlap setting is not as useful as other settings. Click on cluster column chart again and choose any of the columns. Go to series overlap and try 50%. Some columns almost hiding others. Maybe it's useful if we want to give attention to a specific column. But as I said, it's rare to use it. Thank you for watching. Bye.